Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Hola a todos, bienvenidos de nuevo a mi canal.
In today's video, we're going to talk about submitting a family-based petition for your parents. So if this is the first video you're seeing on my channel, I highly recommend checking out my Immigration to the US All You Need to Know playlist. I will link it in the top right corner of this video as well. In that playlist, you will find everything you possibly need to know about helping your relative immigrate to the United States. Anything about family-based petitions, Form I-130 is going to be the form that you submit. And to keep in mind that you can only petition for your parents if you are a US citizen. So if you're a green card holder, you cannot yet petition for your parents. However, if you have just recently naturalized and you would like a petition for your parents, you can go ahead and do that. I frequently get asked a question how long I'm supposed to be waiting after naturalization for I can submit this petition. And the answer is you can submit as soon as you have all of the required documentation, as soon as you fill out the form, and as soon as you have all the supporting documents that you need, you can go ahead and file it. There's not a specific time frame that you're supposed to wait before petitioning. So the next couple of quick things is that if you are petitioning for your parents who are currently in the United States and you are a US citizen, obviously, your parents are considered immediate relatives of a US citizen. And if they are currently in the US, you can go ahead and file the petition for alien relative, which is the Form I-130, together with their application for green card, which is Form I-485, adjustment of status application. So you can go ahead and file that together, those two forms. There's other forms involved in the process, but these are the two main ones. And this is known as concurrent filing. When it comes to concurrent filing, you can send these two and all of the documents, all of the supporting forms by mail, or you can file your I-130 online. And then once you get the receipt notice from that, you can use that receipt notice to input with your adjustment of status application and also mail it off. But if your parents are currently overseas, the only thing you can submit for them is the initial petition, the I-130 application. Again, you can also do that by mail or online. You're obviously going to have to wait for your I-130 to be approved, transferred to their local NVC. That will then continue handling the family immigration case. It will reach out to you and tell you what the next steps should be. The next thing to consider is if you are filing for two of your parents, keep in mind that you will need to submit a separate I-130 petition for each of them, because each immediate relatives of US citizens must get a separate petition. So the filing fee for the Form I-130 is $535 currently. Now let's talk about the supporting documentation and the evidence that you need to submit for this petition. Unlike the spousal petitions, parent petitions are a lot more straightforward and a lot faster and a lot less taxing when it comes to the amount of evidence you have to submit for the Form I-130. So the first thing you should know is, as a petitioner, you will need to provide proof of your US citizenship. So that would be either a copy of your American passport, a copy of your naturalization certificate, or a copy of your birth certificate if you're born in the United States. Next thing, you will need to provide a proof of your relationship to the person for whom you are petitioning. So your proof of relationship to your parents or parent. So in this situation, if you are petitioning for your mother, you should be submitting a copy of your birth certificate with obviously your mother's name listed on it. If you are petitioning for your father, You can submit a copy of your birth certificate with, obviously, your father's name should be listed on there too, as well as a copy of your parents' marriage certificate to show that your parents were indeed married to each other. And in the case that you are petitioning for your step-parent, you will also need to provide your parents' marriage certificate to show that indeed your step-parent became your step-parent prior to your 18th birthday. The other thing to consider is that your step-parent doesn't have to legally adopt you in order for you to become immediate relatives. You will automatically be considered immediate relatives as long as the marriage between your parents occurred prior to your 18th birthday. So, and if your parents that you're petitioning for or step-parents have been married prior to other people, make sure that you're also submitting proof of their divorce certificates showing that their previous marriages ended prior to this current marriage and prior to your 18th birthday. So that is something to keep in mind, obviously. All of this is also outlined in the form I-130 instructions on page 8. That talks about what kind of proof of relationship you will need to submit. And that is that, honestly, so far as proving the relationship between you and your parents. As you can see, this is very drastically different compared to the petitions for spouses, where spouses need to prove that their marriage is bona fide, which means that their marriage is real, and the amount of evidence that needs to be submitted in that case is obviously a lot bigger. So in this case, for parent petitions, those are the only things that you will really need to submit. And if currently your parents are in the United States, you're not required to submit a copy of their passport or a copy of their visa or a copy of their I-94. However, if you're sending it in by mail, you can include that information if you really want to. But again, that is not a requirement. And another thing is, it is also not a requirement to submit passport style photos. So if you are researching the I-130 petition online, you may have noticed that for at least spousal petitions, you do need to provide passport style photos of you, the petitioner, and also the beneficiary for this application. However, when it comes to parent petitions and most other relative petitions, you actually don't need to include those. So the other thing to note is if you are sending this application by mail, you will want to include a cover letter. I do have a video talking about cover letters and what they are. Basically, a cover letter, basically in short, explaining who you are, whom you are petitioning for, and the documents, the list of documents that is included in this packet in the application. Having a cover letter is a really good idea. Also, if you are filing concurrently, like I said, with the adjustment of status application, just because adjustment of status applications will also require a pretty big amount of documents to include. So you can also use a cover letter for that. You obviously don't need a cover letter if you are submitting the I-130 application online. And the great thing about the I-130 application online is that based on the type of petition you're submitting, at the very end of the application, it will only require you to submit, to upload the evidence that is required for this case. So I would say that the online application is a much better guide in this situation, so to say. I had a couple of people ask me questions about the I-130 that I think I'm just going to address here instead of making a separate video. So question was, can I go back after submitting my application and change any information. Unfortunately, no, you cannot do that. Once your application is submitted, you won't be able to change it. But if you've noticed that you have made a mistake, I definitely think you should reach out to USCIS, either try to speak to a representative on the phone or through the chat bot on the online on USCIS.gov. If it is a very menial, very small mistake, that shouldn't be an issue. If you have completely forgot to fill out entire portions of the application, that could be potentially an issue. And the other question that I frequently get asked is, at the end of the online application, there are fields to upload religious records, civil records, DNA records, census records, stuff like that. So that type of evidence is not necessary. It is optional if you have provided all of the initial evidence that we have talked about, either in this video or other videos. If you are, for example, trying to prove your status as a US citizen and you don't have a copy of your birth certificate on hand, and then you went to your local state to ask them for a copy of your birth certificate, and they say that they cannot find it and they misplaced it or something happened to all of this information that it got lost, that is when you would use that last page with additional evidence to submit affidavits, for example, from the government that says we lost this person's birth certificate and proving that you were indeed born in the United States. Or if, for example, you are looking for a birth certificate to show that you are indeed related to your parents, or if you're looking for your parents' marriage certificate from a different country, for example, and it's unable to be placed, then in that case, you would want to use other ways of obtaining this information officially in order to prove this kind of documentation. In majority of cases, it's not going to apply to you, because if you have everything that is required initially as stated in the form instructions, then you won't need to provide any of that and you can just skip that portion. So as you can see, the petition for parents is a little bit easier. You being a US citizen petitioning for your parents makes them your immediate relatives, which also helps with processing times as well. Unfortunately, I cannot tell you how long it will take for your parents to get their green card. It all depends on whether they are inside or outside of the United States, the processing center in the US, or if they are in another country, how fast their local embassy or consulate is working. But either which way, I hope that everything works out for you with the help of my videos. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I hope to see you in my next videos. Ciao!